Welcome back. Fox 8 News in the morning. With Lent underway, fish fries are a popular dinner option for a lot of families. But you don't always have to go out to a restaurant if you want to have some fish. Jim Bernhardt is a chef at 1833 Restaurant, the hotel at Oberlin, and he's here now to fry up some beer-battered walleye for us. Jim, welcome.
Absolutely. Thank you, Wayne.
Talk about 1833. So, interesting name.
1833 is named after the founding of Oberlin, the town, the city, mm-hmm. as well as the Oberlin College. Tons of history, really nice town, a lot of good restaurants. So, we're gonna prepare this beautiful beer battered walleye
All
here.
All right, let's get
walleye
to work.
Right out of Lake Erie. So first thing we got to do, Wayne, is make the beer batter. If you want to go ahead and take those two flours there.
Oh, okay.
We have rice flour and all-purpose flour.
Just put them in there.
Dump it right into the bowl.
Okay.
I'm gonna crack a beer here. We got this nice OG lager from Market Garden Brewery.
Okay. So both flours in there, huh?
So we have all-purpose flour, rice flour, and a little bit of baking powder.
Okay. And then.
And then we're going to go ahead and add in the beer. Here we have some vodka. I don't use
water
in my beer batter.
Oh, my
goodness. All alcohol here, you know. The alcohol actually evaporates faster than water, so it makes for a fluffier, crispier crust.
So you got to do a whole can of beer.
How
much? Just a little bit of vodka?
About a cup and a half of rice flour, cup and a half of all-purpose flour, a tablespoon of honey. Honey will help to give it the color.
Okay, yeah. Interesting.
That nice golden brown.
Oh, this is the batter that we're doing right
Absolutely. Absolutely. And a little baking powder.
Okay.
So you just whip that together.
Yes, sir.
Get a nice paste formed. Mm-hmm. And then kind of by the miracle of television, I have the batter ready to rock and roll right here in my slicer.
Let's rock it. Let's roll it.
So you go ahead and take that.
That's what I'm talking about.
And you squirt it right over top.
Mm.
Whoop. Oh, the fish there.
That's okay. Don't worry about it. You know, cooking can be, when it's messy, it's good. There you go.
And then you drop that right in the fryer.
Okay, now what kind of oil are we talking about there?
So here we have just olive oil. It's
good.
A neutral flavored oil, super healthy.
You want to put that other one in there?
No crazy stuff going on
Because I think the girls are pretty hungry this morning.
Absolutely, yeah.
You might as well put that other one in there.
We'll go ahead and fry that up here. Stand back, Wayne. We don't want to make a big mess here with this siphon.
Oh, my gosh.
So
that's
that kind of helps to keep things neat, but it also helps to keep the batter nice and fluffy.
Now,
right?
Is this on the menu all year long or just during the luncheon season?
So this is something that I put on the menu just recently.
Okay.
Really, Wayne, we change our menu about every 2 months just so that I can stay in the season. Right now, we have three fish options because it is Lenten time. So we have a nice smoked salmon dish.
Okay. Ooh.
We also have a nice... pan roasted Lake Erie perch as well.
Ooh,
it's kind of a different take on Lake Erie perch. A lot of people bread it around here, but we pan roast the skin side, get it real crispy and delicious. So
now,
what did you
put a few of the? Can I put a couple of?
These are
a different take on fish and chips.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
So here we have some fingerling potatoes that are just blanched,
and
kind of like in the style of a tostone, which is like a plantain. We just kind of smash them and fry them, and they get really nice and crispy on the outside.
And you put them in there with the fish, no big deal.
And put them right in there with the fish, right? No big deal at all.
So we're just
going to cook this fish until it's nice golden brown.
It's looking good already, I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And it's smelling good. You can smell that beer batter, man. It's smelling, you know, pretty good there.
So as the fish is frying, these potatoes start to get nice and crisp. So we just go ahead and pull those potatoes right out.
See, you're talking my language today. Fish and chips kind of thing?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, yeah. What's that location at, just in case?
We're 10 East College Street, right in downtown Oberlin.
Downtown
right on...
Oberlin.
58 in East College Street, right in the heart, right across from Tappan Square. Beautiful location.
And if, in fact, you're ambitious and you want to do this at home, the recipe, as always, on our website, fox8.com, and on our Pinterest page.
Absolutely.
Now, what are you doing there?
So here we're kind of making like a warm potato salad with those crispy fingerling potatoes. So we're taking a little bit of pickled onion, a little bit of cornichon, some frisée, which is like a bitter chicory, a little bit of flake
salt. How do you eat that? Just dig in?
Just dig in. Yeah, absolutely.
And what are you putting on there?
A little olive oil. Ooh. And then in the bottle here, I have a little Chardonnay vinegar, right?
Spray it. I like how you spray that.
So it's all about staying neat.
What a great idea to spray it.
I know.
Because vinegar,
it's a good-looking dish, too.
Absolutely.
What a great idea.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, no.
So this fish is all beautifully fried right here. Ooh. Nice and crispy. Look at that. You can hear it. You can hear that crunch.
Oh, my gosh.
Right? So as soon as it comes out of the grease... I like to hit it with a little flake salt. Okay, I don't use too much salt, but I like to use a nice sea salt.
What's that sauce?
So we have a red tartar sauce here.
Oh.
So Why is it called red tartar sauce? We put a little bit of Korean chili paste in it.
Oh.
So it gives it just a touch of spice.
It gives a little spice. Yeah.
And then the rest of the ingredients are really traditional. Sweet pickle relish, a little bit of garlic, some lemon.
Yeah.
So we go ahead and to plate this, we just stick the potatoes right down with all those pickles and cornichons and the bitter frisée.
Gorgeous.
Is it ready to go yet?
We just go ahead and put the fish right on top.
Look at that.
And, man, put the other one on there.
That's brilliant.
That's a beautiful thing.
Little peppery micro watercress from my good friend Lee Jones down at the Chef's Garden. So.
Oh, we love that. We just had, he was here in studio yesterday.
Absolutely, absolutely. I saw that.
Yeah,
I saw that.
He's the best.
So please, go ahead. Give it a try.
Okay, let's give it a try.
You hear that? That's beautiful, isn't it?
Crunch.
Listen to that.
That's a nice crunch.
And that's that rice flour, but also this soda siphon that's charged with CO2. It's very nice.
Is it hot?
No, excellent. You'll love it. Let me try that.
Look at this.
Wow, that tartar sauce is
good, huh?
Pretty much amazing.
Yeah. That's how we roll. That's how we roll down in Oberlin at 1833.
Wow. Thank you, Jim. Appreciate you, man.
I like how you roll.
Gotta get you back on the show.
Thank you.
Do something else.
I'd love to come back.
Oh, this is fantastic.
Excellent.
All right, while we dive into this, should we take a break?
we'll be right back.
Best compliment of chef.
Fox 8 Recipe Box is brought to you by Dean Supply.